Hi, I'm Julie. First of all, sorry for my French accent. Nonetheless, so today I'll talk to you about how Python can be used for spatial analysis without any spatial modules. So I work in a research lab with many geographers. I work with geographic information systems. My job is to collect, analyze, and visualize spatial data. So I'm not a programmer. Just a few words before beginning about the difference between raster data and vector data. It will be useful later on. So raster data is pictures. If you zoom in, you can see pixels. The size of the pixels is called resolution. For example, JPG or PNG are raster formats. And vector data, it can be points, lines, polygons, and they are defined by coordinates. If you zoom in, you won't see pixels. Voilà. For example, SVG is a vector format. There are not many of us. Is it okay for everyone? You can talk to me while I'll talk. It's okay. Okay. So today I'll talk to you about a research project called GeoOps, and this project studied spatial data infrastructures, which are geocatalogs, catalogs with lot of metadata about spatial data. So we extracted this metadata and with Python, but this is not the subject of this talk. And one part of this project was about how the French territory is covered by this French geocatalogs. Is the territory covered everywhere the same way? Are there some zones which are well covered and some which are not? So the metadata were collected from 37 geocatalogs, and we looked at the geographical extents for this data. There were 160,000 extents in 2016, 190,000 in 2017. You can access the data on the French Open Data website. And here is what it looked like at first look. So you can't see much here. Just a lot of rectangles. On the right, you can see that the data is just it's just a CSV file with four columns for north, south, west, and east coordinates. Well, there was quite a lot of cleaning before coming to this, but I'll not talk about this now. And what I wanted to do was to visualize which zones were well covered and which were not, and also to visualize evolution between 2016 and 2017. So, what I wanted to do, you saw I had a lot of rectangular extents. I wanted to have flat polygons with a number of superpositions. And then, within a GIS software, I can vary the color depending upon the number of superpositions, and it's easier to see where there are lots of superpositions and where there are not. So I first tried with PostgreSQL and PostGIS, which is a quite powerful tool and which is often used in GIS. It went very well for small data sets, but it was too long for the complete data set. The query went on for days, even weeks, but it never finished. So I had a look with Python. Python is quite used for spatial data. My idea was to consider each extent as a matrix filled with, as an array, filled with 0 and 1. So here you can see an example. This is the whole Earth. Pale blue is 0 and darker blue is 1. So this is a rectangular extent for French Guiana. in South America. And then you can easily add up every extent. So the scripts are all on GitHub. It's very simple. It first creates an array filled with zero for the entire Earth surface. It goes through each CSV lines and adds one to corresponding array cells. And it converts the result into an ASC file, which is raster data, which can be read by GIS softwares. What it looks like, here you can see much more. It wasn't my job to make interpretations, but the researcher in the project could see quite a lot of things here. So the darker the blue, the more superpositions. Mm-hmm. And it completed the job in about 45 minutes. But it meant that since it is an array, I did not work with vector data anymore. It was raster data, so I had to set a resolution. It was not a real problem because I could set a resolution that was consistent with the scale of the maps I wanted to make, of about 2 kilometers here, and the execution time was okay. So I could produce different maps using this script. As a quick summary, PostGIS was faster for smaller datasets, but Python was much faster for bigger datasets. I'm not saying Python will always be faster. It depends on what you want to do. Maybe I could the PostgreSQL server I use could have been optimized, but my Python script could also have been optimized. Mm-hmm. And here you can see the execution times for the two methods. You can see it's faster for PostGIS for small data sets, but if you have more extents, it's just not possible. Second thing I wanted to talk about. Now I have raster pictures, and I want to compare two pictures for two dates, here 2016 and 2017. So then again, I tried with traditional GIS tools. It was too slow because the raster files were very big. I tried with Python. So the job was to subtract two arrays. Quite simple. But here I had a bit of a problem. I understood that I should not store the whole file in memory because then my computer crashed. But I had some problem reading only chunk of the files and then going on. I got a friend to help me, and it worked. And up. So I could produce another file. Here I use hot colors for increases in superposition number of extents and cold color for decreases. On this particular map, you can only see increases. That's about it. What I could have done? I could have used spatial modules. I'm thinking about GeoPandas to work with vector data instead of raster data. I know there are a lot of spatial modules in Python. Here, I didn't have much time. I wanted to do something quick and dirty without learning anything new. What's interesting is that for a GIS person without much knowledge of Python, it worked. And also, I think for Python people without much knowledge of spatial data, you can do interesting things. I could have read more about memory usage in Python. This I found a bit unclear. I could have written a plugin. And do you have any ideas? What would you have done? No? Thank you. No questions?